Shalom, this is Levi Shor. Welcome back to Swing Good Torah. So we're going to learn something incredible today. We're going to learn the Ten Sefirot of the fingers. We'll learn a little bit of the Kabbalah of the fingers. So we're going to jump right in here. We're just going to swim on top of the surface of an ocean of Torah today. So we're not going to go in very deep. It's a very deep topic. We're just going to get a little sense of it. And Bezrat Hashem in the future, we'll go in deeper and we'll learn more about it. All right, so I'll make this my right hand. It's really my left hand, but everything's backwards. So the 10 sephiros of the fingers, or the 5 on this hand. So this is going to be keser. This is chachma. This is chesed. This is tiferes. And this is netzach. And then on the left hand, this is going to be, the thumb's going to be bina. This is gevura. This is hod. This is yesod. And this is malchus. All right, so we're going to bring up a screen share. We're going to learn a little more about the amazing qualities of the fingers. So let me see when you bring this up. All right, so it says here, so it's Masekta Kesuvos 5a, if you want to look it up. So it says, Jerash Bar Kapara. So Bar Kapara, he says, he taught. So my Dixiv, what is this pasuk? Why does this verse say? Vayaser tiyelecha al azenecha. That is, and you will have a peg among your weapons. Azenecha is your weapon, or your weapons. And then it says, then the Gemara says, al tikre Azenecha, don't read it like your weapons. Ela, rather read it al aznecha. Read it that it's on your ear. So she'im yishma adam devar she'eino hagon. If a person hears something that's not really appropriate, then what a person can do is a person can stick the finger in their ear, and they can not listen to the lashon hara, the evil talk, or the motzi shemra, the defamation. You know, the slander. So it's interesting. So it's one interesting use of the fingers. And there's a much deeper meaning here. But one aspect we're coming into is that these fingers, the 10 sephiros in our fingers, the fingers are very holy. They have great kedusha, great holiness in them, and they should be used for holy things. So let me bring back up the share here. So then we're going to learn more about each individual finger. So it says here, let me see. So let me get it up here. So Yaniach Etzbo Biaznav, right? So a person can place the finger in his ears, and he wanted to listen to the Yetzihara. So V'hainu Demar Rabbi Elazar. So that is what Rabbi Elazar said. He said, Mifnei Ma Etzbo Osav Shel Adam Damos Lisados. Why the fingers of a person? Why are they similar to pegs? My Taima. What's the reason? Ilema Meshum Demichalkov. That they We say that every finger is, because they're separated from each other, kol chada v'chada de milsa avida. That each finger, because Hashem created each finger separate from each other, each finger has a specific purpose of what it does. So domar mar, zo zeres. So the little finger is called the zeret, and we'll see what this is used for. And then the next finger down is called the kamitza. And then the next finger down is called the Amma. And then the next finger down from that is the Etzba. And then the thumb itself is called the Gudal. And we're going to see that each one of these has a specific purpose. So the Zeres, here, let me bring back up, bring up the camera here. So the Zeres, the little finger, so this was used to measure the Choshena Mishpat. And then this, the next finger, I believe, here, let me go back to the screen share for a second. The next finger was, I believe, called the it was called the kamitza. I'll show you how it works. So when the kohen was doing a when they're doing taking a mincha, a flower offering in the temple, so the kamitza here next to the little finger was used to scoop the flour, and then the excess flour could be wiped off, and then you have the kamitza in there. That was your kamitza. And then the next, let me see, this is a little tricky. Wait, what? The next, it's a little tricky to get the two screens to work here. The next is the Amma. So the middle finger is the Amma. And what was the Amma used for? And the Amma was used to actually measure the measurement called Amos, or an Amma was the middle finger was used for that measurement. And then the next finger, so let me bring this back up. So then the last two fingers, they are the longest, and they were used for applications. I believe the Kohen would use this finger to sprinkle the blood on Yom Kippur, on the prokes, the special curtain separating the Kadosh, the Kodesh HaKadoshim, the Holy of the Holies, and then this was also used for applications of blood. So we see that the fingers have very holy uses in the Beis HaMikdash, in the temple. And one of the main points I want to make today is, even though we're not going too deep into the subject, that these are very, very holy, and they should really only be used for holy things. So just a PSA, a public service announcement for all you kids out there, don't join secret societies. Don't make the crazy OK666 hand sign. Stop doing these ridiculous Illuminati hand signs that some of the celebrities are doing. The hands should be used for holy purposes. They have great power in them. The sephiros themselves are in our fingers, and our fingers should use for holy things, for good things. Use it to give tzedakah, to help people. Use it to pat your friend on your back when he needs, you know, to be cheered up. Use our fingers for good and for kedusha, for holiness. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope to see you back soon on Sweet and Good Torah.